Hi viewers, good day. Welcome to vSparks. Today we are going to see what is container orchestration, the tools that are available for container orchestration, and an intro about Kubernetes. If you like this video, please subscribe to vSparks channel and click the bell icon for the latest updates. This is the agenda of this video. We are going to discuss on these topics in this video. Containers so far. So far, what we have been doing to run a container. We'll be installing Docker in an operating system, which gives us the container runtime to run the containers. On top of this, we will be running our containers by executing Docker commands. But do you see a gap here? Yes, of course, we do. Here are the gaps or the questions that arises here. How do you automate your container deployments? How do you scale up or scale down your workloads based on the needs? How do you load balance them? Lastly, how do you monitor and upgrade your environments? The answer for all your questions is container orchestration. Now, what is container orchestration? Container orchestration does automates the container deployments, scaling, monitoring, networking, and management of containers. With container orchestration, you can automate your container deployments. It monitors your container workloads. Suppose, say, if your container is down, it tries to bring back the containers in an automated manner. Container orchestration engines automatically scale up or scale down your containers whenever the load increases or decreases. It also helps in upgrading your environment from one version to the other version. These are the core functionalities of container orchestration engine, which we have seen in the last slide. Apart from these, it also does these things as its prime responsibilities. Scheduling of containers. Scheduling means placing the containers in the right node based on the configurations given to it. Resource management. Managing the base machine resources like CPU, memory, etc. effectively by placing restrictions in the containers so that the containers with the resource limits or restrictions cannot consume more resources from the base machine than what is specified. It takes care to load balance the workloads. It takes care of the container networking too. There are other responsibilities as well, which we will see it later. Now, let us see the various container orchestration engines available in the market. First is Kubernetes. Kubernetes is an open source container orchestration engine. You can install Kubernetes in your physical or virtual machines, and you can deploy your workloads on top of it as containers. In this case, you need to take care of everything starting from your virtual machines or physical machine till the container deployment. If you don't want to take up this burden, you can go ahead for managed Kubernetes engines where the underlying infrastructure is taken care of by the service provider himself. Only thing is, you should take care of your container deployment. That's it. Few such solutions are OpenShift from Red Hat, Docker Swarm from Docker, Apache Mesos, and public cloud solutions like Amazon EKS, Azure Kubernetes Services, and Google Kubernetes Engine. Now, you would have got some idea about what is Kubernetes. Now, we will see a bit more about it. Kubernetes is an open source orchestration engine which is used to deploy, manage, and automate containerized workloads. More importantly, it is an open source. It was originally developed by Google and it was donated to Cloud Native Computing Foundation in the year 2015. Why people are going for Kubernetes? Here are the answers. It helps to deploy the application more faster. No need to wait for traditional physical or virtual machines from the infra team to deploy your applications. You can straight away go ahead and deploy your applications in the Kubernetes cluster. Kubernetes is much more cost efficient. It is infrastructure agnostic. For example, if you are running your application workloads in the on-prem physical Kubernetes cluster, the same can be moved to the cloud-based managed Kubernetes cluster without any code changes. Create once and you can run anywhere is the concept here. As I said earlier, there are cloud-based managed Kubernetes services which will reduce your burden in managing the infrastructure. Now, we will see how a Kubernetes cluster looks like. Kubernetes orchestration engine is not a single component. It is a set of nodes that runs containerized workloads. Here the nodes are nothing but the machines, which can be physical or virtual. These set of nodes collectively form a Kubernetes cluster. If you say you are running Kubernetes, then it means you are running a cluster. Kubernetes cluster is comprised of master nodes and the worker nodes. Master nodes are responsible for scheduling, controlling, and maintaining the cluster itself. It is also called as control plane. On the other hand, worker nodes are responsible for running the actual workloads or applications in the form of containers. Based on your workload, you can spin up as many as worker nodes as you want. Well, that's it for this lecture. This is the summary which we have discussed so far. Thank you from VSparks and thank you for watching this video.